So you've done your lift, you put your tires on, you've done whatever else. Does Eyesight still work? Well, today I got some boxes. Got a 2015 Subaru Outback Premium 2.5 with Eyesight. For those of you that aren't familiar with Eyesight, it's basically a system that employs two cameras at the top of the windshield, and they detect the cars in front of you, obstacles, different issues. Like, for example, if you're going too fast around a turn, Eyesight will see that it's a turn if you're in cruise control, and it will actually reduce the cruise control to give you a safe speed. Let's say you turn your turn signal on to get over, it'll actually give it a little more gas to allow you to pass. Because typically when you do that, you know, your cruise control set at 65, well, the adaptive cruise control has it at maybe 55 because it's tracking the car in front of you. So it anticipates a turn signal, starts to speed up so you can get over and not have to do as much input as a driver. Good or bad, it is what it is. I personally love the adaptive cruise control system. It has taken away a ton of anger when doing long distance driving. It just works very, very well. So I keep getting the questions, does it still work? I've got 3 inches of lift, basically, 2-inch Anderson Design and Fabrication lift, as well as a 1-inch off-road Subaru springs. In addition to that, I have the winch bumper on the front, the steel bumper made between me and Costa Fabrications, as well as the Easy Pass and the tires, which are Turo 235 6517 Trailblade XTs. So what we're doing today is just to do a live test and see if the Eyesight works. We're going to do two different tests. One's going to be at 25 miles per hour, and one's going to be at 35 miles per hour. I'm not going to do much more, mainly because the majority of people use adaptive cruise control in traffic, from what I gather on boards and stuff like that, where you're using it so you don't maybe have to be as alert or as paying attention, you know, playing Pokemon Go, stuff like that. Not me. I don't do it. Well, I play Pokemon Go, but not while driving. But we're going to do 25 and 35 to simulate basically neighborhood conditions, small road conditions, and test it like that. So for the test, we have 3 boxes that are empty. The bottom one has a little bit of weight in it. It's nothing that's hard or anything like that. So for some reason, I do hit it, that I'm not going to scratch or mess up anything. The other two are empty boxes. They're all taped together. It's roughly the size of 2 to 3 people standing next to each other. So it's actually a little smaller than a car and maybe a little taller than a normal car is. So figure maybe like a smart car, maybe like the from the backside of a smart car or the Scion IQ, something like that. So we're gonna line up. This is a closed down road. This is a neighborhood that's under development here. So I didn't wanna do it on a public road, but I still wanted a normal road because the Eyesight actually picks up the lines on the road and lets you know like when you're gonna cross a line or you know you're swerving your lane, stuff like that. So I wanted to make sure it was a legitimate road and not just a parking lot, so we had the lines. And we're gonna go to the back, we're gonna start up. I said again, we're gonna do 25 and then 35 test, and let's see how it goes. Let's give it a try. So I did 25, which was almost no issue. The adaptive cruise control just caught it, slowed down. I did 35, which it started to slow and then had to do emergency braking. And now we're gonna do 45. We're gonna go ahead and do 45 and let's see what happens. Is about the limit on where it's gonna work. So with 35 miles per hour, we still had a little bit of room. At 45, it wouldn't stop the accident, but it's not gonna be as bad a damage as would have happened if you didn't have Eyesight. Now, I don't know the actual numbers for where it's supposed to work, given the situation that Eyesight is not a replacement for a driver, it is not an autonomous driving system. It's there as an accident mitigator and to lessen the impact of accidents. If something stopped in front of you at 45, even without Eyesight, you're probably gonna plow into it if you see it at the last minute. With Eyesight, basically what it does is it senses it, slows some so that you feel that you need to slow, and then at the last minute, it slams on the brakes. Now, if you're paying attention, as you should, when you get that first initial braking input from the car, it should snap into you, say, hey, we need to slow down. And then you would apply the brakes a lot harder, thus getting onto the brakes harder sooner as you're driving and completely mitigating the accident. Again, Eyesight is not a replacement for being a driver. As you can see, at low speeds, 35 miles per hour and under, it's gonna work. My main goal was to make it at 25 miles per hour. I think the test is a success. I'm sure there's gonna be somebody, oh, well, it should have worked at 45. You know, I don't know, go test it yourself. Take your stock car, set up the same test, let's see if it works at 45. I mean, that's the only thing I can tell you guys. Be aware of your driving. It's not a replacement. It's an enhancement to your vehicle. It's off-road Subaru, drive safe, and let us know what you want to see in the comments, all right?